Hello everyone. Admittedly, this picture is not by René Magritte, but it is inspired by one of his most famous paintings. Today we will be looking at a custom-made knife by Philippe Delayou. He is a very talented knife maker from my neighbor country Belgium. If you happen to be a member of the Usual Suspect forum, you probably know Philippe Delayou. He regularly posts photos of his knives on this forum. But you can also see a lot of his knife creations on his website deviantblades.com. Philippe's approach to the knife market is quite unique. Like any other knife maker, he makes really high-end custom knives with high-end price tags, of course. But the concept behind these friction folders is different. The initial idea was to make an inexpensive knife that is legal in virtually every country. Yes, I can already hear you scream, "This is a Spyderco copy!" Calm down, my friends, calm down. Philippe Delayou licensed the thumb hole or spider hole from Spyderco, so everything is fine. Now, what we've got here is quite an interesting mixture of the modern with the old. We can easily identify the sources of inspiration here. The overall shape was inspired by Bob Lam's Chinese folding knives. As you may or may not know, the famous custom knife maker Bob Lam made this traditional curved shape popular in modern knife design. You probably have seen the Spyderco Bob Lam Chinese folder. Then we've got another modern design element, the thumb hole, which of course goes back to Spyderco. Also, the materials used are very modern. The handle scales are Red G10 and the blade steel is RWL34, a modern premium powder steel that is made in Sweden. It features a very fine grain structure. From what I've read, this steel was specifically designed for hunting knives, where the prime concern is edge retention. Also, RWL34 is the favorite steel of Jens Anso, the well-known Danish knife maker. Now take a look at the locking mechanism. Yes, you are right, there is no locking mechanism. This is a friction folder, a non-locking folding knife. Friction knives are some of the oldest folding knives made by man. These lever-operated folding knives were already known in Roman times. It is just the friction between the blade and the handle scales that keeps the blade open. And as you can see, the frictional force is very well adjusted. The blade cannot be closed by gravity. While the knife is in use, there is pressure against the edge from the materials you are cutting and also from the surface or underlay you are cutting on, which prevents the blade from closing as well. Also, the lever is very useful while cutting. The blade is kept open by your hand grip or by your thumb or index finger pressing on the lever. So yes, you need to be a bit more careful than with a locking blade knife, but if you don't act like a fool, it works pretty well. Let's go over the specs real quick. The closed length is 11.8 centimeters. The overall length is 16.5 centimeters. As for the blade length, if you measure from here to the tip, it's 7.4 centimeters. In other words, the blade length is clearly under 3 inches, which is an important figure in some countries. The blade thickness is 3 millimeters and the weight comes in at 93 grams. I already mentioned the blade steel, RWL34, which I have no experience with so far. The blade shape resembles some of Spyderco's typical leaf-shaped blades. Speaking of Spyderco, size-wise, this folder is similar to the Spyderco Persistence. The handle is a little shorter though. Just for some more size comparisons, here is a Spyderco UK PK. And let's also compare it to a Spyderco Delica. As for the blade shape, look at this very pronounced belly of the blade. The belly almost starts at the beginning of the cutting edge. I really like this wavy line. The blade comes with a full flat grind and has this nice satin finish. You can deploy the blade with one hand either by using the lever or by using a combination of the thumb hole and the lever. Actually, the opening and closing is very smooth. As far as I know, Philip uses Nylotron washers, which are high quality washers with excellent wear resistance. Since there is no locking mechanism, the handle construction is very simple. There are no liners. There are just these two red G10 slabs. Of course, there is a pivot screw and there is a pin on the inside for the blade stop. This pin holds the blade in position when opening the knife, and it also prevents the cutting edge from hitting the backspacer when closing the knife. The noise comes from the tang hitting the pin, it's not the blade hitting the backspacer. The backspacer is held by two screws. All screws are countersunk into the handle scales, so it's all flush. The handle scales are nicely rounded. The G10 texture is not very aggressive, it feels very comfortable as the whole handle does. The overall fit and finish is very good. The only minor imperfection I was able to detect is the blade centering. The blade is a half a millimeter off, but that's nothing to be worried about. The spacing between the handle scales is wide enough. And please remember, this is a kind of entry-level custom knife. I will not tell you what I paid for it because I don't want to interfere with Philips' price policy, but it is way less than you would normally expect for a custom-made knife. So, if you live in a country where one-hand folding knives with a lock are not allowed, this friction folder is an interesting alternative to a typical production slip joint like a Spyderco UK PK or a Swiss Army knife. Yes, it's special. Maybe you need to be inclined to knife history a bit to appreciate this mixture of the old and the modern, and you probably have to get used to operating this knife. There is one thing you should keep in mind if you EDC a friction folder like this. There is no detent to hold the blade in the closed position, so you shouldn't carry this knife in the pockets of your pants or your jacket just like this. This knife can accidentally open in your pocket and hurt you. So keep it in a pouch or in a compartment of your bag where the knife cannot open inadvertently. I hope you enjoyed my little review. Thanks for watching. Take care. Bye bye.